Okay, so we're here at this air conditioner. What we have is when there's a call for cooling, the compressor turns on, the fan tries to turn on, but it doesn't start spinning. But if we take a chopstick and stick it in there and spin the fan, it'll actually start spinning, which to me makes me think that it's probably the start capacitor that's not working on this fan, maybe the run capacitor. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a look at the capacitor, we're gonna test it, and then we're gonna replace it. But our very first step, of course, is to pull the disconnect so that there is no power, make sure that there's no call for cooling. All right, so we got the side of the unit here open. Right, we can see there's the two capacitors. There's one down here, which will be for the compressor most likely, and then this one up here will be for the fan, a start and a run capacitor in there. Right, and we have to remember with capacitors, they have that ability to store a charge. So before we touch anything, we just want to take our screwdriver and run it across the terminals. Right, make sure that if there is any stored charge in there, we are discharging it. Right, and then what I like to do in order to test these capacitors, you know, properly is actually disconnect them from the circuit. So once I've discharged them like that, then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a picture of all the terminations in here. Right, so I can see where all the wires go. That way when I go to put the capacitors back in, I can make sure I terminate them properly. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull these capacitors out, and then we will take a look at testing them on the table. So here I've got the capacitors taken out because it's a lot easier to work on them when they are not actually installed in the unit. And I know I already did this in the unit, but I'm just again gonna take my screwdriver, run it across the terminals just like that, just to make sure if there is any charge in there, it is completely discharged now that it's disconnected. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna test these capacitors. So I got my meter here. I'm just using a Klein meter. Doesn't matter which one, as long as it has the microfarad setting. So I'll turn that on and I'm gonna test this first one here. When I read the settings on this one, it should be between 135 and 162 microfarads, and it's a 330 volt capacitor AC. So I'll get my... So sometimes these meters take a little bit to register. So it's good to make sure you get a really good contact on those contacts and hold it very, very still. You can see the meter is thinking and it tells me it's 160 microfarads, which is exactly in the rating. So I know that this capacitor is good. Bring over this one. And now before I took it off, right, I took a picture of where all the terminals go. I'm pretty sure that this over here on the left is my common point. And that one of these is my fan start and the other one's run. Can't get the meter to register anything on these. There we go. So that says it's about 40 microfarads from there to there, which that sounds right. So it looks like it might just be this one here, my 5 microfarad capacitor in there, that's actually faulty. Let's just double check if we can get that to register at all. Yeah, I'm not getting anything to register on that one. You can also check from different terminals just to see what you get. And again, nothing registers. So I'm pretty sure it's this 5 microfarad capacitor in here, right? This is a dual capacitor, so there's actually 2 inside of here. So I think that's the problem. So I'm gonna get a new one, replace it, and see if that fixes the problem. So the store didn't have a direct dual replacement like this one. This was a 40 microfarad and a 5 microfarad dual capacitor, so 2-in-1. So instead, what we're gonna go with is we're just gonna replace both of them. I know through testing, technically we only needed to replace the little 5 microfarad, but the cost was so low, we're just gonna go ahead and replace both of these at the same time. So I'll have to jumper together the 2 common points. So I built this little jumper, just jumper together the common points. So just like it was on the dual, and now I'm gonna take my picture and I'm gonna go over into the air conditioner. I'm gonna start wiring this in. Okay, so I got the new capacitor mounted in here. I got the wiring that I can hooked up. I'm gonna drop the fan on, the fan goes on, and we get one of the fan wires onto the start capacitor, the other fan wire onto the run capacitor, and then we go from there. So I'm just gonna drop the lid on and do that. All right, so because I took the pictures, I know exactly where all these wires go, but I'm just gonna double check my picture one last time because I forgot. All right, so I bring my brown from my fan down to this capacitor. My purple from my fan goes to this common point up here, right? And our commons are jumpered together with the jumper. And then lastly, my fan termination. I also took a picture of it. It was up here on my contactor, and that's my run for my fan. I tuck it all inside. Now what I'm gonna do, before I put this cover on, I'm just gonna test it and make sure that it all works. So we fired it right up and it started running no problem. So it's definitely the capacitors that were the problem. So thanks for watching this video. If you have to change your own capacitor, right, just make sure you're being very, very careful with that stored charge. Make sure you're checking them. And if you're uncomfortable at all, make sure that you call a professional. Thanks so much for watching.